हेलो चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम बैक इन द सेकेंड चैप्टर फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड वॉर एंड रशियन रिवॉल्यूशन लेक्चर नंबर सेकेंड। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैड सीन अगेन दैट हाउ द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द 20th सेंचुरी वॉज मेनली डोमिनेटेड बाय द फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड वॉर एंड द बोल्शेविक रिवॉल्यूशन। वी ऑल्सो सॉ हाउ द यूरोपियन कंट्रीज स्टार्टेड कॉलोनाइजिंग द एशियन एंड द अफ्रीकन नेशंस एंड दे स्टार्टेड रूलिंग this nations and started robbing them. We also saw how in Asia, okay, due to the Opium War, China was ruled and became a victim of the European nations. Same way, Africa also became a victim even after the Berlin Conference in the year 1884. Okay, Africa was divided into different parts. It was divided into different parts so that they can be ruled without any competition. So without wasting time, let us go further. Now, what were the factors that led to the First World War? Now, this is very important. Okay, as I told you, First World War is very important concept for us. So what were the factors that led to the First World War? Now, from the first chapter, first video, you have already understood that due to the greediness of this nations, European nation, due to the greed of expanding territories, European nations, First World War rose up. But there were certain factors due to which First World War actually broke up. So we are going to see about the factors that led to the First World War in this particular video. See, the First World War could be considered as one of the most heartbreaking and unfortunate event of modern world. See, it is considered as one of the most heartbreaking and unforgettable events of the modern world. Many factors were responsible for this. See, not one factor, but many factors were responsible for it, and we are going to study about those factors here. The First World War began on 1st of August 1940. Okay, so 1st of August 1914, but actually the event started 1 month back. Events starting for the First World War started 1 month back. Now, the seeds of First World War were basically, you can say, almost 50 years back. Okay, they were into a war between Germany and France. This was into a war between Germany and France that was known as Sedan War. It was known as Sedan War, and it took place in the year 1870. Sedan War took place in the year 1870. Now, in 1870, what happened? Germany had defeated France, and because of which France had to sign the Frankfurt Treaty in the year 1871. This is the photograph of Frankfurt Treaty, which was signed in the 1871. Now, according to this treaty, what happened actually? See, according to this treaty, France had to pay war fine. See, France was forced to pay war fine. Okay, war fine is the expense of the war. Okay, and that was round about 5 billion francs. That was 5 billion francs. As well as they gave away 2 provinces of it. Okay, not only 5 billion francs, but also 2 provinces, 2 areas of France. The name of the areas are Lorraine and Abyssin. Lorraine and Abyssin to Germany. Now, France could give, but what was the problem? That this both areas, Lorraine and Abyssin, were very rich in minerals. They were very rich in minerals, and Germany would get all the minerals out of it and become very, very rich. So, due to this treaty, Frankfurt Treaty, Germany had humiliated France in a very bad manner, and France was like, you can say, it was like a hurt lion. It did not like it. Okay, so France had not been able to overcome this humiliation. They were very humiliated and they did not like it, and they could not overcome it, and they wanted to take a revenge, and Thus, you can say the Frankfurt Treaty itself caused the First World War. Okay, so Frankfurt Treaty was one of the reasons, one of the main reasons for the First World War. Rather, it was one of the, you can say, triggered the situation that that made the First World War start. They made the First World War start. The end of the war sowed the seeds of a future war. See, this treaty was seeds which ended up in future war, which ended up in future war. So we can conclude by this that the 1870 war, the Sedan War, which took place between Germany and France, was the seeds of the First World War, was the seeds of the First World War. Now, what were the main reasons? Then first reason, first main reason was the economic factor due to which the First World War started. England had established its vast empire in Asia and Africa in 19th century. This we already know. It exploited its colony economically and became rich. What did it do? It exploited the colonies and it became richer on its own. Due to the industrialization and swift colonization, European required huge quantity of raw materials. See, as there was industrialization. Industrialization means growing of industries, and colonization, they needed raw materials. Okay, so they needed areas from there can get raw materials at cheaper rate, and also they needed markets to sell their finished products to them. In the last quarter of 19th century, Germany had started the competition to procure the market in Asia and Africa. So Germany also entered this race, and it also started acquiring areas into Africa and Asia. Germany had started supplying cheaper goods in comparison to England. See, now what did Germany do? Germany started supplying cheaper goods in comparison to England and France. And due to this, England and France had incurred a loss. They started incurring a loss. They started incurring a problem. The Afro-Asian market that England and France dominated, the Afro-Asian market that England and France dominated, were thus broken up by Germany. So due to this, the market, which was controlled mainly by England and France, was now broken up by Germany, and consequently there was an intense economic competition between England and Germany. And due to this, Germany and England became arch rivals. They became rivals of each other due to this colonial rule. Okay. Let us see which was the second factor. Now, second factor was militarism. Military forces were necessary and important for the competition that the European nation got into for expansion. Say, military force was also needed for the expansion. England, France, Austria, Russia, etc. had begun expanding their military power. These were the nations which started growing their military power. While in countries like Japan, Italy, Germany, compulsory military training had started. See, this all countries realize that without fighting they cannot acquire nations, and that's why they started compulsory military training. See, compulsory military trainings in those nations. Production of weapon was increased under the pretext of self-defense. Production of weapons started production, okay, increased under self-defense. They are saying that we are growing this weapons, we are making these weapons for our self-defense, not for fighting. Thus, militarism got an impetus, got a support, got a boost, and military competition added economic competition, created serious atmospheric war. And due to this, there was serious atmospheric war and competition. The third reason for the starting of the First World War was groupism. Now, there were secret treaties between different nations. Groupism and secret treaties played a major role in the First World War. So, groupism means forming groups, and secret treaties were formed. The world was divided into two groups before First World War. Say, before even the starting of the First World War, the world was divided into two groups. On one side was the group of Germany, Austria and Hungary, Bulgaria and Turkey. So this all nations were on one side, while on the other side was the group of England, France, Russia and Japan. So one side there was England, France, Russia and Japan, while on other side there was Germany, Austria, Hungary, Bulgaria and Turkey. A feeling of jealousy, enmity means to create enemies, mistrust, not to trust, fear, hatred evolved between groups, which was an important factor for the First World War. You can see in this particular photograph, this green color are nations which were together and they had made secret treaty. That treaty was known as Triple Alliance. Okay, Bulgaria had made treaty with Austria and Hungary and Serbia also, while Serbia had made with Russia. You can see, right, they were known as the Balkans, right? And the year Russia, France and England had got into a treaty, and that was known as Triple Entente. So here you can see all the nations were forming groups at the same time, they were also forming secret treaties. The fourth factor is the fierce nationalism. So fierce nationalism was very important. The independence of Belgium and Greece and the unification of Germany and Italy. Now we have already discussed that Germany and Italy unified, and due to this unification, okay, the nationalism arose. Now what is nationalism? Nationalism basically means feeling of oneness for the nation, feeling of oneness for the nation. But later the feeling of nationalism took an extreme and narrow form in Europe. Okay? But later on this nationalism turned into narrow form. Narrow form means they thought that their country is the most important country in the world, and they started robbing, they started destroying, ruining other nations without thinking about them. Economic jealousies, competition and colonialism in Europe had increased so much that the interest, national interest of such of each other began clashing. They started fighting with each other. Leading European nations began teaching extreme and destructive nationalism to people. See, they even started teaching nationalism to their own people, and they were making them ready for any event like war or any fight. Love for own nation and hatred for other nation was encouraged. See, love for own nation means you love your country, while hate other country, such kind of mentality was encouraged. The German chief Kaiser William, okay, this person Kaiser William was the first person who started such kind of mentality, was the originator of nationalism and colonialism. He was over ambitious. He was very ambitious and wanted to make Germany the best country in the world, and believed in world leadership. He wanted to get things done according to his will with the help of grand military power. The feeling of war spread across other nations as in Germany, and this had resulted in the First World War, and due to this the First World War started. So we'll keep till 4. There are 6 reasons for the First World War. We'll keep till 4. You need to read about them and understand it for your easy understanding.